Now, chapter 25, we have here the kingdom. After the great tribulation, the Lord Jesus comes, he ends it, and then he establishes the kingdom. And this chapter brings us into the kingdom age. That's what the Old Testament's all about, that there's coming the king, and there will be the kingdom of heaven upon this earth. Now, that's what John the Baptist meant when he began his ministry, "Behold, the kingdom of heaven is at hand." The Lord Jesus took up that message, "Behold, the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Now, our Lord, when they rejected the king, you can't have a kingdom without a king. When they rejected the king, there's no kingdom. And then he could say privately, personally now, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I'll rest you." That's still his invitation today. It is a message to be sent out to individuals to exercise their free will. And my friend, you're making a decision, whether you know it or not, whether you believe it or not. You either make a decision for him or reject him. And somebody says, "You don't get me on that. I will not make a decision. I will not accept him, and I don't reject him." You don't? Listen to him. "He that's not for me is against me." You have to. There's no such thing as neutral ground. Now, we come to this wonderful 25th chapter, and it's a song. And this song has three stanzas here. We have first five verses, "Praise to God for deliverance from all past enemies." You see, now they've entered the kingdom, no more enemies. "Praise to God for provision of all present needs." Be wonderful to have someone here that will be able to meet the needs of mankind. Verses 6 and 8. And then, "Praise to God for anticipation of all future joys." That's verses 9 through 12. Now, will you listen to this? "O Lord, thou art my God, I will exalt thee, I will praise thy name, for thou hast done wonderful things. Thy counsels of old are faithfulness and truth." This is praise to God for deliverance now. They now are in a time of great blessing, and this is a song of sheer delight and wonder and worship. And this comes from a heart overflowing, for the worshiper now has come into a new knowledge of who God is and what he's done. This is not the average song service that you have in a church on Wednesday night. Some of the saints sitting there wondering why in the world they came in the first place. May I say to you, this is those that are eager to worship God because of faithfulness and truth. Now, these are the attributes of deity, and they are foreign to humanity today. The scripture says, "Put not your confidence in man. Put not your trust in man." Isaiah's already said it. And faithfulness is the fruit of the Spirit and not the work of the flesh. And truth is the very opposite of man. You remember David said, "All men are liars." But David said, "I said it in my haste." Dr. Carroll used to say, David said, "I said in my haste, all men are lies." Dr. Carroll said, "I've had a long time to think it over. I still agree with David."